morning guys, it's Kritika. Welcome back to my channel. I'm in Sora right now and the plan for today is we are going trekking to the double-decker route bridge. Now I am a bit skeptical of this trek because my fitness level isn't the best right now. But my mom isn't going. My dad, Vikram and I are planning to go on this trek. Fingers crossed we'll be able to make it. But this is the resort we're staying in. We got here last night. It's called Kutmadan and it's quite nice. This is the view. Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. That is our room. We just had like a nice breakfast here and we are gonna be on our way to Double Decker Route Bridge.
Life is a winding road, no telling where it goes. Driving through days and nights, won't stop for traffic lights. And I...
So after a 1 hour drive, we've reached the spot from where our trek is going to start. I think it's near Tirna and basically the trek is going to start from here. It's about 3,500 steps one way. So we go down 3,500 steps and then come back up 3,500 steps. So it's definitely not an easy trek. I am honestly a little bit worried about how I'm going to climb back up. Going down is going to be easy, but coming back up, we'll see how it goes. But we are already kind of behind schedule because we started late today. So we're going to start our trek and then on the way, I'll talk more about this place and share some more facts.
I really want to know, really want to know.
Basically, the four of us are trekking together. So there's my dad, there's Vikram, my brother, and Roy, our guide. So of the three of us, Vikram is the fittest and he treks a lot. So it's going to be the easiest for him and he's also the most excited. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling?
I'm very excited. I'm excited to go and swim.
In the water, yeah. Yes. And my dad doing this trek is kind of the reason I was also like, okay, let's do it. Because in the morning, I kind of thought that, okay, let's skip this. So how are you feeling?
Yeah, feeling great. So this should be a test of my strength. Let's see. I should be able to do it.
And here's Roy, our guide. How difficult is this trek?
No, madam. Many people it's difficult to climbing up only.
Yeah, going down is easy.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we'll try to do it.
Okay, yeah, we have to do it. Yeah. Also, our guide here, Roy, he understands and sort of speaks a little bit of Tamil as well, which is very cool. So yeah, like Roy said, going down is easy, but coming back up is going to be a challenge. So initially I was worried about the whole coming back up to the point where I considered not doing this trek. But for now, I'm just going to enjoy this trek, enjoy the hike down, and then we'll worry about coming back up later.
Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down.
Tasting some wild pepper.
Not bad. Oh, it's actually tasty, yeah.
So we're done with 1000 steps. The steps are actually quite steep and my knees when I'm standing now is kind of wobbly, so it's a bit scary. But this is where we are right now and that there, Nongriat village, is where we have to go. So quite a long way ahead.
Jumping from cliffs so high, trusting our wings to fly. Sometimes we're crashing down.
Okay, now I'm starting to get worried about how we're gonna come back up because these steps are quite steep and now that we can see the actual steps, earlier we could only hear 3,500 steps and we were like, okay, that's doable. But now we can see like so many steps. It's definitely not easy, but I'm sure it's gonna be worth it once we're there.
We can start from the ground.
We're done with about 2000 steps. That was quite tiring. I thought going down will be easy, It was easy, wasn't that hard, but the steps are steep, so my knees are kind of wobbly now. But right now we're in this village called Nong Khe Mai. We're just stopping to have some lemon juice and refresh ourselves. So let me tell you a little bit about this place. So Sora is one of the wettest places in the world, and because of that, wooden bridges don't really last long here. So the locals here, they've basically come up with this concept of living root bridges. So I'll ask my guide for more details, but basically there are trees here which have roots which are very strong, and that's what they use to build these bridges. It takes apparently about 15 years for these roots to be, like these bridges to be strong enough for people to walk on. But once they're built, then they last forever. I think the double-decker root bridge, if I'm not wrong, is 150 years old. So apparently these root bridges weren't very popular before among tourists, but basically there's this Tamil banker who married a Khasi woman. So he kind of moved here, opened a hotel. It's called Cherrapunji Holiday Resort, and he sort of went trekking and made it popular among tourists. But anyway, our lemonade is ready. We're just gonna have some of that and then get going. Let's figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. So this here is a pineapple tree, and there are apparently lots of pineapple trees along the way. This is such a scary bridge. Highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky. Whoa, this bridge is so scary, but look at that view. This bridge is constantly shaking. Even if the sky is falling down, even if the sky is falling down. So there's the bridge, and now the last part of our trek, which actually involves climbing up, which is good in a way because when we come back, this is going to be like a downhill slope. So we have like, I think, 1,000 steps to climb up now. The sky is falling down, yeah. The sky is falling down, down. So this is how the bridge is made. There's like a steel rod. And in like 10-15 years time, this will sort of become like that root bridge you see there. Even if the sky is falling down, yeah. The sky is falling down, down. Finally made it to the double-decker root bridge. It's right here behind me. So here's one level, here's the other. Sitting here and enjoying the view, there's the root bridge. There's actually a lot more people here than I expected, but I'm just gonna take some shots and then probably jump into the water. The water is so cold. I jumped into the water. The water was amazing, and right now not many people are here as well, so the vibe is very peaceful. And just ordered ourselves some Maggi, so just gonna sit and enjoy the view and have our Maggi. beautiful place. I don't feel like leaving. A lot of people actually come and stay here at a homestay and then the next morning do the hike back because it's quite strenuous. But we are doing it the same day and it's already 3 p.m. So we have to leave now if you want to make it back on time before the sun sets. But I absolutely loved it, and right now especially because there's no one, it's just so beautiful. Now starts the hard part of today, which is the hike back. So I think the last part of the trek where we were mostly climbing up, that part should be easy because we have to climb down now. But 2,000 or more than 2,000 steps up is going to be a challenge. So yeah, I don't think I'm going to be vlogging. I'm going to put my camera inside, save my energy for the hike up, and I'll see you guys once I reach the top. Have about 500-600 steps more. The climb up has been quite difficult. We're just taking a stop now to eat some fresh pineapple. We did it, almost back to the top. This trek was definitely not easy, but finally made it back to the top. We did it. How's everyone feeling?
Yeah, amazing.
I don't think we'll be able to feel our legs tomorrow. Already my thighs are like, I'm shaking when I'm standing. But feeling super accomplished that we did it. And thanks to Vikram for pushing us to do this. Because otherwise, we were not planning on doing it.
Thanks to Kiki and Vikram, both of you. I was able to do it.
Yeah, but our face is so red now. That was quite an intense trek. Yeah. But yay, we did it. Back in the resort now, showered and feeling clean. My legs feel like jelly. I don't know how I'm gonna feel tomorrow, struggling to walk right now. But for dinner today, we have a barbecue thing going on, and there's a bonfire there in the back. And I just thought I'd quickly talk about the trek. It was amazing, definitely worth going. But also, having said that, it's definitely a difficult trek. So if you have any knee issues or if you're traveling with like older people, I don't know how my dad did it, but I'm glad my mom didn't do it because she has knee issues, and definitely not recommended for people who have knee issues. It's quite a strenuous trek. I feel quite accomplished now having done it. I honestly, like I mentioned, was in two minds about whether or not to do it, but it was very beautiful and totally worth it. But right now, super hungry. I think we've earned our meal today. So just gonna have some really nice barbecue dinner and call it a day. Back in the room now, and that dinner was really nice. Bonfires are always amazing, although my hair smells like smoke now. But anyway, today has been such a fun day. I wasn't expecting it. I was honestly so scared of this trek because I'm not really into trekking that much. I don't do that many treks, but I'm so glad I did it. It was so much fun. We still have 3 more days to go in Meghalaya, so lots more videos coming up. Tomorrow we're visiting some waterfalls, going to these caves nearby and doing a bunch of other things, and also visiting Kong Thong village, which should be fun. So do subscribe to my channel and I'll see you guys in the next vlog. Bye.